Hi everybody, my name is Brooke Haggerty and I am so excited to welcome you here today. Thank you so much for joining me for Faunalytics 2021 roundup of our accomplishments from the year, as well as a sneak peek of what we have planned for the year to come. I'm really excited to just celebrate the year we've had with you and to let you get to know Faunalytics a little bit more. So, out of respect to for your time, I'm going to try to keep this to under 30 minutes, but we do want to save time for a quick Q&A at the end. So if you didn't get a chance to send us your questions, please feel free to drop them in the comments. I will try to answer them, or our communications manager, Jenna, will be on standby to answer all the questions you may have. Before I begin, I do want to give you a disclaimer. My apartment building is under construction, so if you hear any noise in the background, I am so sorry about that. Bear with me, and hopefully we can make it through. So with that out of the way, let's begin. 2021 was such an incredible year for us here at Faunalytics. We've really done so much, both with our programs and behind the scenes, and one of the biggest things I want to share with you is that we were named a top charity by Animal Charity Evaluators. This is after several years of being a standout charity, and we are truly just honored to be recognized as one of the most effective charities in the animal protection movement. So we are going to work very hard in the coming year to live up to this title and to bring you so much more important new research and resources in the year to come. So thank you to all of you who helped us achieve this. Being named a top charity is truly an honor, and it wouldn't have happened without all of your support. So thank you first and foremost for that. Our original research program is where I want to start today, though. We have three primary programs: our original research, our research library, and our direct support program. And our original research program, this year we published four studies. We have four in progress that you're all going to see very soon. And we also have seven studies planned. So really exciting year to come and year behind us. I want to give a shout out to our research director, Joe, and our incredible research scientists, Zach and Andrea, who have made our research possible, as well as the incredible volunteers behind the scenes. This year, we started off the year with our Twitter Trends in Animal Advocacy study. This was an in-depth look at the public's interest in animal protection topics, how they engage with certain keywords and topics over time. And it really gives advocates a lot of insight, especially those who are about to begin veganuary or vegetarian campaigns. We actually found that dietary keywords like vegan and plant-based really spike in the first week of January. So that study has a lot of great insights, especially if you're a marketing or communications advocate. Do be sure to check out our Twitter Trends report. We also have really an exciting series of studies on new vegans and vegetarians. This is called our longitudinal study on going vegan or vegetarian. Parts one and two we've published this year. Part one being many paths to one goal, and part two that we just released a few weeks ago, motivations and influences. So for folks who are working on individual advocacy or vegan outreach, dietary outreach, really check out these studies. We had so much data because it was a longitudinal study looking at the first 6 months or so of when people change or are trying to change their diet to go veg. So there's a ton of insights that are going to be really helpful as you help people go and stay on this path. We're going to publish the third report in 2022, so make sure you are subscribed to our newsletter so that you don't miss out on that. And of course, we all know that unfortunately, animal suffering is global. And so Faunalytics has done in the past and in 2021 studies to help the global animal advocacy community. And this year we shone a little bit of a spotlight on China. We really wanted to help advocates working in this region. So at the very beginning of the year, in partnership with independent advocates and researchers, we published a COVID-19 and animals poll, specifically looking at the Chinese public's understanding of COVID-19 and its relationship to animals and animal agriculture. This was a replication of a study we did in 2020, which was US focused. And so we published that early in 2021. And if you're working on animal advocacy in China, you're not going to want to miss that. We also have an incredible line of research going right now on supporting the farmed animal protection movement in China. We released a study a couple months ago that specifically looked at the public perspectives of farmed animal advocacy in China. It was a qualitative study with members of the animal protection movement in China, and we outlined the landscape, bottlenecks, potential growth areas, and opportunities for advocacy in that study. And we also have another part of that study coming out next year where we're going to do focus groups with the Chinese public. So this is really, I think, foundational research to help farmed animal advocates working in China. And I really want to take a second to thank and recognize Hong Kong-based researcher Jia Ying Cheng with the Good Growth Company. She's partnered with us on this study and will partner with us again in 2022, and our research on this project wouldn't be the same without her. So thank you, Jia Ying. Your partnership really has meant a lot to us this year. So later in this talk, I am going to get to the studies we have coming, so stay tuned, but I'm going to stay on our 2021 highlights for a moment and switch gears to our research library program. This is led by our incredible content director, Carl, and our research library is essentially a collection of over 4,500 external study summaries. What we do is we take the research that's out there, summarize it in a short way for advocates, and give you the key highlights and takeaways so that you don't have to spend as much of your time reading research. You can take it in a digestible manner and really get out there and do the work you need to do. So if you haven't explored our research library, again, we have 4,500 articles for you to check out. In 2021, we added 200 more to our study collection, and our research library covers every topic you can think of: farmed animal issues, wildlife, companion animals, animals used in science, animals used in entertainment. There's really something for everybody in that collection. So I hope that you'll take a moment to explore what we have. I also want to share that we do have a blog where we contextualize and synthesize information across topics for advocates. So do be sure to explore our library a little bit. We also recognize that not everybody likes to sit down and read research all day, and so we've made a concentrated effort to produce more visual resources and new videos for advocates. Our Faunalytics Explains video series takes really important study summaries from our library and summarizes it in video format in under 2 to 3 minutes. So if you are more of an audiovisual learner, check out our Faunalytics Explained series. We added new studies on plant-based labeling, aquaculture, conservation, farmed animal imagery, and we have plans to add quite a few more in 2022. We also produced a brand new fundamental. Faunalytics Fundamentals are a collection of data-driven, really in-depth infographics on key topics in animal protection. They're really quite beautiful and great for sharing, and really comprehensive for people who are either just getting into certain topics in animal advocacy or maybe are trying to share and educate others. So our new fundamental this year was on ocean life. We explored marine mammal issues, fishes, cephalopods, everything you can think of under the sea. So be sure to check out our fundamental series and our ocean life fundamental, which is new to Faunalytics this year. I also share that we, every year or so, we do really in-depth analyses of external data sets. So what you might be familiar with is our global slaughter statistics. This is a huge analysis based on FAO data of global slaughter numbers and figures, but this year we did a brand new analysis looking at wildlife imports, specifically the legal wildlife trade and wildlife products coming into the United States. It's a pretty staggering report. We found that over a 15-year time span, over 3 billion live organisms were imported into the United States, and 78% were taken from the wild. That's just one finding of ours. from this really in-depth analysis. So definitely check out our wildlife imports blog and be on the lookout for future in-depth analyses like that in the year to come. We also have lots of fact sheets and other visuals for advocates. We really have quite a big library of visuals to explore. So below in the comments, Jenna is going to be dropping all these links for quick access. Definitely check them out. And something that I'm really excited to share, this is partially 2021 and partially a sneak peek for 2022, is that Faunalytics has begun translating our work. Not only are we starting to translate our original research studies, but we are carefully and methodically going through our library to figure out which resources should be translated professionally for advocates. Like I mentioned earlier, you know, we all know animal suffering is global, and Faunalytics really wants to do more to bring more resources to the animal protection community around the world. So we're in the process of having a bunch of our studies and summaries translated into Spanish, simplified Chinese, Hindi, Portuguese, and we plan on sharing those widely in the year to come. So if you or anyone you know are working on animal advocacy issues and you would prefer resources in additional languages, stay tuned. We have a lot of exciting translated materials on the way. So that's just a quick highlight of our research library and the things we have going on there. I want to share a little bit about our research support program. We also call this our direct support program. And a lot of people might not know about this resource. Faunalytics doesn't just conduct research. We don't just put the information out there. We are advocates ourselves, and we are really passionate about making sure that our community can take what we give you, take the findings, take the data, and apply it to your advocacy. That's half of our job. You know, we don't just stop our work when we publish research, we keep going. And so part of that is accomplished through our Office Hours program. If you have not heard about our Office Hours program, please come and say hi to us. We are here to help you find statistics, find data, fill out your advocacy materials with all the research you need. If you want to figure out how to evaluate your own work, we are here to help you with that. And our office hours, just like our other resources, are free. We offer free weekly office hours to advocates, and we want to help you. In 2021, we helped over 65 advocates and organizations directly, one-on-one support, and we offered additional time zones. We really want to be available when you need us, so we have new office hours. And we also want to share that we can help you in multiple languages. Not necessarily a ton, but our small but mighty incredible team can help you in primarily English and Spanish, as well as Polish and French. So please reach out to us. We are here to help you, and we really want to get to know you. This is also what helps inform our other programs, getting to know what's important to you, where you're struggling, and what we can do to step up our game for you. So check out our Office Hours program. We're also grateful to have had the opportunity to give 18 presentations throughout the year to over 645 advocates. Thank you to the organizations who hosted us, to the conferences who let us speak and share our work with your audiences. We're really excited to get out there. And that number doesn't include the thousands of people we reached through the AMA we held on the vegan Reddit channel. So we're really excited that we're exposing our work to a whole bunch of new advocates. And again, we really are here to help you, and we want to get to know you. So come by and say hi. If you'd rather figure out research on your own, never fear. We also have a huge research advice resource center. Whether you are wanting to learn about conducting literature reviews or analyzing data or research ethics or designing an effective survey, we have an entire center of our website dedicated to helping you with things like this. Our research director, Joe, and our incredible researchers have been working on improving this all year long. So definitely check out that part of our website if you haven't seen it before. So that is just a little preview of our research support program. I hope that we get to see many more of your faces in the coming year. And I want to pivot a little bit to talk about our impact. As an organization whose services are indirect, you know, we don't get to help animals directly. We rely on you to really understand the impact we have. And we do that in a few different ways. I want to share first, our community survey in 2021 was really exciting for us because we were able to improve across most of our key performance indicators. We sent out a survey to the advocates who engage with our work. We received over 400 complete responses, and I'm so excited to share that 96% of you found our work to be high quality. 92% of you agreed that you put our resources to concrete use, for example, to improve advocacy materials or techniques. And 84% of you thought our work is either very or extremely valuable to improving animal advocacy. So we are just honored to hear this, and we really are going to do more to keep improving in this area. In 2021, we actually had over 360,000 website visitors visit us over 600,000 times. So we are continuing to grow and improve and get out there in front of more advocates. And we hope that you will spread the word about Faunalytics. That is one way that you can really help us grow, is make sure you're subscribed to our newsletter and share our content with advocates who might not be aware of our free resources. We also did a lot of work in 2021 to convey this information to you. We really want to do better about showing the impact we have. It's not just about outputs, it's about outcomes, and we know that. As an organization committed to data and evaluating effectiveness, we hold ourselves to very high standards here. So we've done a lot of work to launch a brand new impact center. In our impact center, we summarize our community survey results, our office hour survey results, some of the quantitative information we have from our website analytics and social analytics, and we are working hard to improve quite a bit more in conveying our impact to you. So please check out our Impact Center and let us know how we can improve and how we can do even better in the year to come. So switching gears once again, I want to share a couple behind-the-scenes activities that Faunalytics has been up to. All of our programs are so important, of course, but there's a lot that we've done in 2021 to really improve our structure, our foundation, and the bones of our organization so that we can soar into the coming year ready to go. First of all, I have to thank our incredible volunteers. We have several dozen volunteers who work behind the scenes and help make everything else possible. You know who you are. There are so many of you and too many of you to name, but from our writers and editors in our library to our admin support behind the scenes to the research folks we have working on our studies, we really are so grateful to you. If you want to get involved in our work, definitely check us out. We are always grateful for more volunteers, and writing or editing our library is a really fun way to give back to animal advocacy on your own time from home. This year, we also welcomed new capacity builders. We have our research team, and then we have our capacity building team, as we call them. We welcomed a new communications manager, Jenna, and a new philanthropy officer, Liz, to the team. And they are gonna help really get our information and research out to the community and hopefully help us increase our impact exponentially. So I'm really excited to welcome Jenna and Liz. And I also have to thank our incredible board of directors and our advisors. Our board has done so much work behind the scenes to really just professionalize our organization. They've done a ton of work with me on our strategic planning, and I truly don't know what I would do without them. As an executive director, I feel very lucky to have the board that we do, and we're also going to look to expand our board in the coming year. So I'm so excited to see what our board does and how our board grows, and I want to thank them for the time and dedication they give to our organization. Something else behind the scenes that I do want to share, because it's so important, is that Faunalytics has been working really hard to understand and improve the ways in which we can make our organization more equitable, more inclusive, and we have done a lot of growth in terms of our ourselves as staff members and thinking about how we can do better as an organization in terms of our commitment to diversity, equity, and inclusion. And so our staff has done a lot of readings and self-education on how other issues intersect with animal advocacy. And as a result, we've published a commitment to the actions we're taking to improve our programs, our policies, to expand our team and grow our people. We really have a lot of opportunities for improvement. And so we've published how we plan to go about this for starters. This kind of work is ongoing. It's certainly not a to-do list, but we're really committed to this work. And we are going to share that commitment in the chat. If you have ideas for how we can take this work a step farther and do better, please let us know. We really want to hear from you. And on a similar note, I want to give a shout out to Encompass. I had the privilege of being a part of their new book, Anti-Racism and Animal Advocacy. I was one of many authors who contributed essays to this book. It's really an incredible, insightful read. It's vulnerable, it's honest, and it shows what we as a movement need to do and can do to make our work and our community more inclusive and more accessible. So thank you to Encompass for the hard work you're doing and for letting me be a part of it. It's truly been such an honor. So that is a sneak peek, or not a sneak peek, pardon me. That's a quick overview of what we've accomplished in 2021. That is truly just the top of the iceberg. I am so grateful to the team for all the hard work that we've done. And I'm really excited now to lead into a sneak peek of what we have planned for 2022. We have so much that we want to accomplish, and I hope that you are just as excited about it as we are. We have a lot of research on deck that we have that we're wrapping up right now that I want to share. First of all, we have a new study on beliefs about chickens and fishes and their relationship to animal positive behaviors. We've done this study in the United States, but this year we specifically wanted to look at Brazil, Canada, China, and India. That study is now complete and is in the process of being translated into additional languages. So in early 2022, that's what you're going to get to see. Be sure to subscribe to our newsletter so that you don't miss that study if you're working on advocacy, farmed animal advocacy. We also have a study that I'm particularly excited about called the relative effectiveness of different advocacy strategies. So thinking about all the different tactics our movement brings and engages, what is actually the most effective in terms of changing people's minds and behavior? We were not expecting the results that we got, so you're going to want to stay tuned. It's pretty insightful, and we've put a lot of thought into the recommendations we're going to bring to advocates. So that's the second study we'll have on deck. We also are going to produce the studies I mentioned earlier in this talk, the third and final part of our longitudinal study on new vegans and vegetarians, as well as a second part of our research focused on farmed animal advocacy in China, where we are going to do focus groups with the Chinese public. So that is some of the research that we are already getting started and or are finishing, but that's not it. We recently completed a new research prioritization process and outlined 7 new studies that we want to do in 2022. I want to thank all the advocates who helped us during our research prioritization process. We've done a lot behind the scenes to improve how we choose the topics we cover so that we are having the greatest impact possible, so that our work is useful to advocates and that it has the biggest impact for the animals. And so some of our research in the coming year is actually going to take a look at legislative campaigns. We've done a lot in terms of individual advocacy. We've done some studies related to corporate outreach, but we haven't really focused on legislative work. So we have a few studies coming up. We have our examples of successful anti-subsidy lobbies. We have state-by-state reactions to potential legislative changes in terms of animal welfare legislation. And we also have a study, local laws as strategic stepping stones. And so there's a lot we're going to do in the coming year that you haven't seen from Faunalytics before, but we also have a few more studies for those of you who aren't engaged in legislative work. don't worry, we've got you covered. We have reduction targets by demographic so that we can get specific about our asks and how we approach different people in terms of animal welfare change. We're going to do a substitution analysis looking at whether people who give up cow and pig products actually consume more of chicken and fish products. We really want to be aware of the kind of possible backfire we might be having as advocates. Similarly, a study on humane labeling and whether or not humane labeling backfires. And finally, we're going to estimate the social spread of advocacy. So we have a lot of exciting stuff on deck for the coming year. That's just our original research program. I haven't even gotten into all the other exciting things we have planned for our library. We want to bring you new events in the coming year that we haven't done before to really bring people together in a spirit of collaboration. We want to offer more opportunities to volunteers. There's a lot we have planned. So be sure to stay tuned. And again, if you're not already, please subscribe to our newsletter. So I know I wanted to save a few minutes at the end for a Q&A, but before I get to that, because I know I'm running out of time, I just want to say thank you. If you have engaged in our work or engaged with our work, we do this work for you and we are so grateful to you. I also want to mention that Faunalytics is a nonprofit. We are run entirely on philanthropy and donations. So if you have the means to give, whether it's big or small, we really appreciate every donation, and we're less than $3,500 away from our year-end fundraising goal. So please, if you have the means, we'd be so grateful for your donation. You can also shop. We have a brand new store that we launched this year with some awesome new designs by our content director, Carl. So don't forget to check out our swag store. And of course, if you can't, that's okay. The best thing you can do is share Faunalytics work, subscribe to our website, follow us on social, and share our work with other advocates so that we can have a bigger impact for the animals in the coming year. So thank you on behalf of the board and staff at Faunalytics. Thank you so much for your support and for all you've done. You've made this year stellar for us, and we are so honored to work beside you. So with that, I've saved just a couple minutes for Q&As. I'm so sorry I'm not going to get to everybody's questions, but I am going to try to get to a few. I want to honor your time today, so thank you for sticking with me. If I don't get to your question, drop them in the comments. We will either get to them here on Facebook, or you can reach out to us at info@faunalytics.org, and we will answer your questions there. Or better yet, visit us at office hours, and we can answer your questions there as well. We really don't want to miss you, so please share your comments with us below. So I'm going to start off with, do you provide support for those who need help getting their research out there? If I understand this correctly, do we help other researchers share their research? We'd love to. If your research covers the type of work that we cover, that's part of what our research library is about. We really want to do better at sharing other work in the community, not just our work. So if you've done research that you would like us to consider covering in our library or in our blog, reach out to us. We would love to share that with the community. And furthermore, we'd love to get to know you. So please don't be a stranger. How does Faunalytics assess your impact? Thank you for asking that question. I'll go through it quickly because I did cover that earlier, but we approach our impact in a few different ways. Whether or not you are using and engaging our work is obviously the most important to us. So we have an annual community survey where we try to understand more about how you're using our work, how you value it, the ways you're utilizing it, where we can do better. So our annual community survey is one. We have our office hour survey of advocates we help through office hours. We have pop-up surveys on our original research to see how useful our research is to you. We also look at quantitative data, so our website analytics, and most helpful, direct examples. We really want your feedback and your testimonials. How are you using our work? How have you used it in your advocacy? Please tell us, because these examples are part of how we measure and understand our impact. If you have ever used Faunalytics work to make change for animals, please let us know. info@faunalytics.org. We really want to hear how you've used our work or what we could do to be better for you in the coming year. So thank you for that question. It can be very challenging for us to measure our impact, and so we're really grateful for you for helping us. Let's see, I only have time for one more. What will change or stay the same now that Faunalytics is a top charity ACE by Animal Charity Evaluators? I'm so glad that someone asked this question, because I want to reassure our followers and supporters that Faunalytics, at its core, we're not going to change. We are dedicated to research, dedicated to the data, and we are focused on work that helps you, animal advocates, be as effective as possible. So the core of Faunalytics isn't going to change. We're just going to do more, and we're going to do better of what we currently do. So our hope is that if we are able to grow, if we have new supporters, thanks to our ACE recommendation, we are going to produce more research. We tend to do, you know, 4 to 8 studies a year, depending on the year and the timeline of when studies are released. We want to do more of that. We want to expand our team so that we can bring you more of these resources. We're going to add new videos, new infographics, new research, hopefully new ways to help you. We also do have ideas on how we can improve and particularly work with others in the movement so that we can collaborate. We want to produce an event where researchers come together and share what we're all working on with the broader community. In the future, we hope to launch an ambassador or fellowship program where we can provide paid opportunities to advocates in the movement who want to get involved in research. There are so many ideas we have on the table, and we just want to do more of what you know and love about Faunalytics. So thank you for being tuned into our work, and please stay on the lookout for even more of what we have planned in the coming year. So I am seeing questions come in on the comments. So again, thank you for engaging. Please keep asking those questions. Even after the video is done today, you can continue to engage with us on social. We will answer all those questions in the comments. We really want to get to you and hear from you. So thank you for being here today and listening to me. I am just so honored to be part of this incredible community. From all of us at Faunalytics, thank you for working with us to make this world a better place for animals. We're honored to be beside you, and we know that we're going to have a fantastic year in 2022. So until then, wishing everybody very happy holiday and a safe new year. We'll see you in the year to come.